So, I'll start with this. I have always played it safe. You know, looking both ways 5 times before you cross the street, kind of safe. You see, I grew up in a lower middle class working family with two very overly protective parents. I was an only child. Well, I am an only child, and my parents constantly thought I was going to get kidnapped. So much so that I was never allowed to walk home from school, and I was only allowed to play 2 houses this way and 2 houses that way, which really wasn't that much space in East Point. I don't think I was actually allowed to go in the street or cross the street without permission until I was 13-ish. In addition to being an only child, I was an uninsured only child. I didn't actually have health insurance for most of my life until 2 years ago when I was 24. So from day one of being a curious, an accidental human being, I was always told, be careful, and if you break something, I'm not gonna pay for it. So, I never broke anything. I fractured my wrist once in cheerleading, falling from a stunt, which led to the whole I told you so conversation and a CVS home remedy. At-home medical treatment, no follow-up, just fingers crossed that my hand would heal and I wouldn't look like Quasimodo later. I think it came out okay. So, you can see why I'm so inclined to play it safe and to follow the rules. And I think the most important thing to note is that throughout the years, I started associating comfortability with safety. So, I never did anything that made me feel uncomfortable, and I never stepped outside my comfort zone until now. So, I want to talk about why it's so important to dive into the uncomfortable, and to break your comfort zone. The comfort zone is a natural state that we gravitate towards, that we just want to be in. And because leaving it means increased risk. Increased risk means higher anxiety, and this can lead to a positive or a negative outcome. But the simple fact that a negative outcome could occur could scare just about anybody into never leaving their comfort zone. And never leaving your comfort zone, you can miss opportunities and it can really hold someone back. Which never really bothered me for some reason growing up until recently, when I look back and I see all my friends who've traveled and done things, and I've never done any of it. So, what did I do to step out of my comfort zone? Well, I took my two biggest fears and I challenged them both together at the same time. I'm terrified of heights, and I don't like talking to in front of people or being in front of people. So much so that when I have to hand my musician husband a glass of water while he's on stage, I have to like mentally prepare and like psych myself up just to like step on the stage and hand it to him, which I'm not even doing anything. So I woke up one day and I said, I'm going to be a circus performer. It's true. It's real. It's on this YouTube channel. So I started taking aerial classes 4 months ago. 4 months ago, I couldn't even stand on a chair. Now, I wrap myself up in fabrics 10 to 20 feet in the air and let go. Well, it depends how ambitious I'm feeling that day. I generally do keep to the aerial hoop or the trapeze. I didn't sleep for days before my performance, and I honestly don't really remember it. I remember thinking, dear God, do not fall, and please don't forget anything. But I turned it on and I honestly surprised myself. I loved the feeling and I lived the feeling. And from the moment I caught my breath, I thought, I really can't wait to do it again. Diving into the uncomfortable helped me find my passion. It altered my dreams and it helped me find sanctuary in this really crazy life. Psychologists have found that challenging yourself can help you perform at your peak, which can lead to higher productivity and a higher self-esteem. Arthur Gardner wrote, "If you want to keep on learning, you have to keep on risking failure every day of your life. Simple as that." That's important to hear because diving into the uncomfortable helps you grow. And growing helps us focus on meaning, connection, and purpose, which is a main concept of the transpersonal theory of human behavior. This theory also states that it's inherent tendency to express innate potentials of love, creativity, and spirituality. So, to be more creative, You have to try new things. And you have to fail. And did you know that Albert Einstein failed over and over and over again just to find his brilliant ideas? If you don't challenge yourself, you'll never achieve your dreams. And psychologists say that sacrificing productivity for comfort, while it may feel good now, will lead to regrets in the long run. And you have to think, do I want to live my life or do I want to experience my life? Brené Brown said that the worst thing we can do is pretend fear and uncertainty don't exist. And I have to agree with her. The power of vulnerability can stagnate you. But challenging that vulnerability and fears and stepping out of your comfort zone will change your life for the better. You'll have an easier time dealing with unexpected changes, and you'll find it easier to challenge your boundaries in the future. If you add that to increased productivity and self-esteem, wow, you're a force to be reckoned with now.